much, much better, much better. Gosh, it's so nice to be back. You know, Sue and I went, I think we went around the world.
Yeah, felt like it.
Whew, you know, motorcycle people talk about cars, they call them a cage. And I used to laugh at that until after this week. And then Sue and I put on 3,209 miles. And here's the greatest thing. After our trip of being together for 11 days and all those thousands of miles, we're still married. Praise God. And we didn't get sick. We didn't get hurt. The car ran great. We saw a lot of great people. Saw our new granddaughter, who, of course, is just absolutely gorgeous. I built a trampoline at 103 degrees. Oh, my word. Let me tell you what, if you're ever thinking about how hot as hell, I saw it last week. It was hotter than that. I know what motivated me to keep me away and making sure that I go to heaven where they have air conditioning.
I'm sure they do.
And I'm so blessed. I have a tremendous son-in-law. He's really a great guy. He does a great job with his children. He does a good, you know, great job with my daughter and so forth. But he is mechanically challenged. I wouldn't say that. As far as mechanically it is.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
So my daughter said, "Dad, if you don't put this trampoline together before you leave, never get done." I said, "All right, no problem." So we're out there putting his trampoline together in 103 degrees.
It was.
And the temperature, said if it was 103, it feels like 108. Well, I'm telling you what, I was just sweat from head to toe. We worked for about 15 minutes, and then we had to go back inside. And my little granddaughter, who's 8, just hangs all over me, which I love. She just hugs me and hugs me and hugs me. I said, "Savannah, come give Grandpa a hug." "Ew, you're all wet." But we finished it, and the kids were jumping and everything else, having a great time. So the Lord totally blessed us, and we missed you guys. You know, we have never missed 2 weeks in a row.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you what, it's uncomfortable. It is just uncomfortable. So we thank you for the blessings and the prayer while we were gone, because we just had no problems whatsoever, other than the fact that, you know, the vacation turned into a funeral, and even that was, you know, a wonderful, wonderful thing. So we're excited to be here. Let's open up with prayer. Amen. Lord, open this way.
Remember Sam in prayer.
Okay.
She's still in the hospital.
Yeah, of course, Sam is in the hospital. She's been there for a couple of days. Expect to get out tomorrow. And at the end of the service, we will go see her. And, of course, at the end of our service today, we'll celebrate Pastor's birthday. He's 50. He is 55-0.
He told us.
You know, I remember when I turned 50, I got my ARP letter. Oh my God, that was like, oh, ARP, I must be old. And I got, you know, like, I didn't even want to touch the envelope, right? And I threw it away. And the next month I got another one, and I threw it away. And then someone said, "You know, you get a lot of discounts with ARP." And I went, "Oh, I hope they send me another one." And they did. So the big 5-0 is you're now in the gold portions of your life. So that's pretty sad. So please join us after the service. We'll have cake and so forth. And so just come here and enjoy the great, great celebration of Pastor Kenny turning 50. He's going to be 50. Anybody know that? He is going to be 5-0.
Everybody knows it now.
Let us pray. Lord Almighty, we're so grateful this morning. Father, we're so thankful for all the blessings that you've given us. We thank you, Father, for us being obedient to your word, to be here, Father, to assemble in your name. Father, we ask that you bless every single person here. We ask that you bless our pastor today as we celebrate his birthday. We ask that you just bring the word, Father, touch hearts and touch lives. And we give you all the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on,
amen.
Get up. And meet each other. Amen. How excited you are to be here at the Family Faith Church.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Happy birthday.
Hey, Miss Jeremy.
Good to see you.
Adam, how are you? I'm from Dunedin. Right down here.
Praise God, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, amen. How many's ready to have church here this morning? Amen. Let me see your hand. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God bless, God bless. Amen. If you look at the screen here, it says August 16th, so I got one day left. My brother sent me a text yesterday, and he's like, how does it feel to have 1.5 days left in the 40s? And I texted him back, I said, I'm going to party like it's 1999. He wrote back, that shows your age. So, praise God anyhow. Amen. Let's all stand there. We're going to worship the Lord. We're going to sing page 50. Let's come and have church. Amen. Hallelujah. How many glad to be here this morning? Praise God. Let's give God glory. Let's praise His holy name. Let's come have church to sing praises to His name. Let's come and have church to give glory to His name. Let's come and have church, for Jesus is here today. Let's come and have church with Him today. Jesus is the King, the Savior of my soul. Jesus is my Lord, the Savior of my soul. Jesus is the One, the Savior of my soul. Let's come and have church with Him today. We gather in His name to sing praises to the King. We gather in His name to give glory to the King. We gather in His name. Oh, Jesus is here today. Let's come and have church with Him today. Let's have church. Let's have church.
Sing it with me, everybody.
Let's have church. Let's have church.
Come and wave your hand at the Lord this morning. Father, we just give You praise. We want to be in Your presence today, God. Father, we pray that You move in a mighty way here today. Touch every heart, God. Everybody watching my video, Lord, touch their heart today, God. Father, we give You praise and glory. Hallelujah, God.
Let's come and have church to sing praises to His name. Let's come and have church to give glory to His name. Let's come and have church.
Jesus. We give you praise, Lord. Come on, give him praise. Praise God. You know, this next song is the first song I ever recorded, and I just want to give it to the Lord today. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Somebody say it. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Come on, let's worship the Lord.
Amen.
Come on, let's have church.
This young man turned 17 a week ago.
Thank you.
I remember playing the drums. And Kyle, 2 years old, sitting on my lap. And now he just beats those things for the Lord.
Yes,
he does. Let's give him a hand. He was sitting on my lap, and Pastor Mark Wachstetter, he goes, "Pastor Ken, come up and say something for the Lord." Kyle was sitting on my lap on the drums, and I said, "Kyle, I'm going to sit you on the seat right here just for a moment. I'll be right back." I walk up to the podium and got the mic, and he started crying. I'm like, "Here you go, Pastor." And I went back and got the son. Praise God. Praise God. I'm so proud of him. I got to tell a little story on him. The other day, Laura and I were late picking him up at work. And I texted him. I said, "Look, we're going to be about 15 minutes late." We arrived at work, and he was working in the drive-thru. And I pulled around the drive-thru. I'm like, "Kyle, I thought you got off work at 8:30. He goes, "I did, Dad. I punched out already. But they were real busy, so I went back in to help." How many of those kids don't do that nowadays?
No, they don't.
You got to beg them to do something. Now, if I can just get him to clean his room, I'll really be doing good. Praise God. I can just get him to clean his room. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Let's sing page 55. What a powerful song. Hallelujah. Hope it blesses you this morning.
Tears he turned into joy.
We praise your holy name. Praise your holy name.
Mercy,
every one of us is sitting here today because of the mercy of Christ Jesus. Aren't you glad for that? Hallelujah. Oh, what a great God. All I can think of today is what a great God that we serve. My, there's not one of us here today that's worthy of the price that he paid. But oh, I'm so glad he looked down one day and he said, there's a people that if I just give my life for them, they'll follow me. Wherever I ask them to go, whatever I ask them to do, they'll be willing to follow me. I'm so glad that somebody told me what a great God that he was. He's been faithful all of the way. I've never seen him fail. He'll never fail. And he said, I'm going away to prepare a place for you. When he went away, he still didn't leave us alone. Because he said, when I go away, I'm going to send you back a comforter. Only somebody that loved you so much, that would worry about when he went away, because he said, I'm going to make a place for you. Wasn't that good enough? No. He said, I'm going to see Kamana Hashana. He said, I'm going to send you a comforter. That He said, I'll not only be with you, but he said, I'm going to be in you. Hallelujah. That wherever you go, I'm going to walk right there with you. Amen. Because I live inside of you. Isn't that wonderful today? Amen. What a loving, loving God that we have today.
Praise God. Can we all say, I got something on the inside.
I got something on the inside.
Working on the outside.
Working on the outside.
Telling me everything's going to be all right.
Everything's going to be all right.
You know, the Bible says to be absent from the body is to be present for the Lord. So what do we have to fear?
Yes.
But fear itself.
God is.
How many feels the Lord here this morning? Yes. Anybody?
Amen.
Praise God. Let's give them a hand of praise. Come on. Let's do it right. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. I'm going to ask for Brother Jackson. We're going to take our communion here this morning. If you can come. Amen. You know, Brother Jackson blessed the church, him and his mom. Bought our communion cups this week, and we are just honored that they took that step for us. We was going to do it last week, didn't have enough to serve everybody, so we said, let's do it this week. And he called me last Sunday, says, do you mind if we pick up these cups? You know what? They're blessing us, and guess what? They're going to receive a blessing on top of it. Praise God. Praise God. So as Brother Jackson comes and passes them out this morning, when everybody hold it, we'll take it together. And I want to sing page 43. Brother Bob can give me while they're passing it out. Glory to God, and we're going to sing Jesus Messiah. Praise God.
Praise God.
Yes, Lord, yes, Redeemer, Emmanuel.
blessed Redeemer.
Father, we thank you for this opportunity, Lord. Lord, we know that there's power in the blood of Jesus. We know that, Lord, that you paid the price, your finished work at Calvary. When you said it is finished, Lord, you paid the price in full for our salvation. Father, we praise you. We thank you, Lord, for everything that you did for us, God. We give you all praise and all glory. Father, as we pray this morning, God, we pray for each and every heart in the sanctuary this morning, God. Father, we give it all to you in Jesus' name. Everybody say this prayer with Pastor Ken. Say, Dear Lord, I ask you to wash me with your blood and to forgive me of my sins. Wash me clean. I accept you into my heart, Lord. Right now, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus said, He said, take, for this is my body. Hold your bread up. Let me see your bread. Hey, hold up your cracker there. Come on. Sister Sue didn't get one. We need another one up this way. Oh, it's in the top of your thing, Mother. Look at your lid. There you go.
She got it. She got it.
Praise God.
Yeah, it's a top. It's a wafer's up on top.
She goes, isn't that something? Praise the Lord. We're all struggling with it, trying to figure out what I'm saying. What are you doing? No. Praise God. Jesus said, take and eat.
It's hard to eat.
For this is my body, which is broken for you. Jesus said, do this in remembrance of me. Let's all partake together. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Thank God.
Hallelujah. Somebody say praise God.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Oh my.
Hallelujah. Oh my.
Thank God. Thank God.
Praise
thank
God.
You,
you know, the Bible says, by his stripes we are healed.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus,
hold your cup up. Jesus said this. Cup is the New Testament of my blood. He said, do this often. And as you do it, he said, do this in remembrance of me. Let's all partake together.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let's all lift up our hands and worship the Lord. Father, we give you praise and honor and glory. Father, we never want to forget, Lord, the price that you paid.
Yes.
The price that you paid to transform our lives, to give us hope. In the middle of a darkened world, Lord, we just give you all the praise and all the glory in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to change the order of services. Go to the Bible.
Bless you.
Glory
be to God.
I have sent my only son to redeem you from every curse that has been set forth into this earth. But you are a blessed people today because you have been covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. Know that my love is everlasting. My love is everlasting. Hallelujah, son. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I praise you today.
Praise God. Lift up your hands. Come on.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. How many of God is speaking here this morning? Hallelujah. Right here in Parkwood Springs, God is speaking to his people. Blessed are those that hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. How many's hungry and thirsty for a move of God? How many need a move of God in your family's life? Come on.
Amen.
Hallelujah. How many needs a move of God in your life? Praise God, in your neighbor's life, at your job. Come on, in your neighborhood. How many knows we need a touch of God in the Tampa Bay area? Come on. How many knows we're known as the lightning capital of the world, from Tampa all the way over to Lakeland? God has something in store for this area. I want you to know, because when the Word of God speaks, it speaks like lightning. Come on. That's what David said. Hallelujah. And how many knows we got a great word for you today? Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Brother Bob.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I always love when the Lord speaks. You know, we are the lightning capital of the world, but you know, you can be the light. You know, you can be the light in someone else's life. And all it takes sometimes is a simple word. You don't have to go real deep into it. But a simple word. Those of you who are in Sunday school this morning, where we talked about honor and respect, and sometimes, and we even gave an example about if someone is mean to you, and believe me, there's a lot of mean people out there, how do you handle that? Do you come back with mean, or do you come back with love? And Jesus wants you to come back with love. And boy, sometimes that's hard, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Sometimes you got to grit your teeth, don't you? Sometimes you got to really take your hand and just make yourself smile, because sometimes it gets rough out there. We know we've got some celebration to do today. We have two birthdays today. Of course, we have Kyle. His birthday was last week. And Pastor, his birthday is tomorrow. And then if you'll forgive me for a second, I got a special present that I want to give the pastor.
Uh-oh.
You're in trouble.
Somebody
says
it's a Barney costume.
Oh my gosh. why can't I show love?
Barney was love.
It's not a Barney costume, I promise.
Obviously.
I promise you it's not a Barney costume. But Pastor, you come on up here. No. And Kyle, come on up here. We want to say happy birthday to you. You know, this is the time of the service where we tell you how important it is for you to give, how important it is for you to tithe your money.
Right.
And you can tithe your money in many ways. You can tithe it the way Sister Pauline and Brother Jackson did, by donating and paying for those communion capsules that you just had. You know, they paid for that. And it's so grateful when you give. We really do. And you know, we've never asked you to give money to the church. What we'll tell you is to give to the Lord. Give it to the Lord. This is the Lord's house. Okay, we have bills to pay, but the Lord will provide that. We don't need your money, but you need to give. And I just want to embarrass Kyle a little more. You know, he's been working now for what, 6 months, 8 months? You know, something like that. Do you realize this young man tithes his money? You know he's real quiet, but I watch him. And when I was taking offering, you know, there was a $20 bill. How many 17-year-olds do you know that would turn around and give a $20 bill? Because it's the real tithing. See, the Lord knows what you're doing. So when you get that dollar, is that your real tithing? That's up between you and the Lord Almighty.
Amen.
But I just want to brag on him, because he's a 17-year-old boy who's been going to church forever. Went to Sunday school a long time ago, and it's back in Sunday school when he was taught about tithing. And all of a sudden, he's now in the world to make money, and no one had said, Kyle, you will tithe your money. There it was. And he'll be blessed. He'll be blessed.
Amen.
So let's just go ahead and sing for both of them. And happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Pastor Ken and Kyle. Happy birthday to you.
And many anymore.
We really would like you to open that right now. That's a special gift. Okay. Make sure. See, he's a very big Rays fan.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. Nice. Look at that. Official Rays jersey. You want to tell the story, you want me? Revenge.
Yeah. It should have been 40.
Even after 17 years ago, Kenny and I were playing on a church softball team. And I was traveling and they ordered new shirts for the team. But when they came back, there was the number 5. Number 5, Babe Ruth. Number 8, Yogi Berra. Number 9, Roger Maris. When I got my shirt, it had a 50 on it. You know why? Because I was 50. I was the old man of the team. And I remember sitting in a dugout, and I heard these young guys saying, you know what, that old man really hustles pretty good. And I heard another say, you know what, that old man hits pretty good. And I'm sitting there thinking, who are they talking about? It was me. So 17 years later, my son, I got it.
Oh, man.
That, and there is no 50 on a Rays team. No 50 on a Rays team.
That is too good.
Just a little bit of fun and a whole lot of love. And happy birthday to a tremendous, tremendous grandson and a really, really great son that I'm very proud of. So with that, let's take our offer. While they're collecting that, Pastor, I will deliver a card from the church with love and appreciation. Thank you. Let us go before the Lord. Heavenly Father, we just give you love this morning. Father, we're so grateful for all that you do. Father, we're grateful for the ability to create and make these offerings to present it to you, Father, to present our tithes to you. And Father, we just thank you so much for everything. We thank you for the other 90%. We thank you for each and every person who's here this morning. We thank you for the blessings and the love. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 I will say 17 years ago, it was funny.
No.
Don't laugh about it, but now he got me. I deserve that. Thank you, Bob.
It was funny. I remember him saying, why did I get 50? Praise God.
If you have your Bibles this morning, I would like you to turn to the book of Numbers. Numbers chapter 3. And I'm going to read verses 5 through 13. That's Numbers chapter 3. Beginning at verse number 5. The Bible says, then the Lord said unto Moses, call forth the tribe of Levi and present them to Aaron the priest to serve as his assistants. They will serve Aaron and the whole community, performing their sacred duties in and around the tabernacle. They will also maintain all the furnishings and the sacred tent, serving in the tabernacle on the behalf of all the Israelites. Verse 9 says, assign the Levites to Aaron his sons, for they have been given from among all the people of Israel to serve as their assistants.
appoint Aaron and his sons to carry out the duties of the priesthood. But any unauthorized persons who goes to near the sanctuary must be put to death. And the Lord said to Moses, look, I have chosen the Levites among the Israelites to serve as substitutes for all the firstborn sons of the people of Israel. The Levites belong to me. Everybody say, it belongs to me. For all the firstborn males are mine. And on the day I struck down all the firstborn sons of Egypt, of the Egyptians, I set apart for myself all the firstborn in Israel, both of the people of the animals, they are mine, and I am the Lord. Let us all pray once again. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we give you all praise and honor. Father, I pray, God, that you help me to rightly divide the word of truth today. Lord, your sacred word, Lord, is alive today in our hearts, God. And we pray today, God, that you speak to every heart. We pray, God, that lives are changed here today by the power of God. We pray, God, that every word that comes out of my mouth is anointed of God. We pray that every heart that hears this word today is anointed so they can receive your word today, God. I pray that I do no violence to your word, but God, let me be sensitive to your spirit and let the Holy Ghost speak here today in Jesus' mighty name. Can somebody say amen.
Amen.
Praise God. My message title this morning is Chosen to Serve. Can we all say that together? Chosen to Serve. Now Jesus said in Matthew chapter 22, he said, for many are called, but few are chosen. Now I have today two questions I want to put before you that I want you to ponder over in your mind. Number one, do you think that things just happen by chance? Or do you think that things happen for a reason? Yeah. Come on.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Now I want you to know that we all have a destiny to fulfill. All designed by God. Guess what? God knew your name before you were even born. Come on. How many knows that God knew you, how many hairs was going to be upon your head and what color of hair you were going to have, what color your eyes were going to be? He knows your destiny because he is the beginning and he is the end. How many knows he's the Alpha and the Omega? Amen. He's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Right.
Amen. And when it comes to God, God has a destiny for you.
Yes.
That he wants you to fulfill. He has a place and a purpose with your name on it. And God wants to direct your steps and lead you into all truth and show you his glory and show you his power. How many wants God to show you his power?
Amen. Yeah.
Glory be to God. Now Jesus said in John 15 and 16, he said, for you have not chosen me. Think about this for a moment. This was words in red. He says, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. Yeah. I want you to know something this morning. You didn't just choose God. God chose you.
Yes, he did.
Come on. God chose you to be a Family of Faith church today. God chose you to give you direction in your life. God chose you and gave you a destiny to fulfill in him.
Amen.
He says, for I ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit.
Yes.
That your fruit should what? Remain. That whatsoever you ask the Father in my name, he will give it to you. How many knows we have power in the name of Jesus?
That's right.
Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen. That's right. Amen.
He said, all you got to do is ask. And you shall receive. Speak unto that mountain, and it will be moved. How many knows we got power in the name of Jesus?
Right.
Come on,
amen.
Brother Curtis, help me preach. Come on, somebody say amen.
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 Now, God wants us to bring forth fruit that the fruit should remain. I want you to know that we have power and authority in that name. I want you to know that that authority has not diminished. That power is the same. That blood still washes clean. That blood has never lost its power.
That's right. That's right.
Now, this past year, I have spent the majority
of the year preaching on the tabernacle. And today I'm preaching my third message from the book of Numbers as we continue on our study of the tabernacle. We find that the book of Numbers was written by Moses around 1450 BC. And I find that there are valuable lessons here for our everyday lives, even today in the year 2015. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Now we find that the events of this book began in the second year after the Israelites departed Egypt as they camped near Mount Sinai. We find that the book of Numbers essentially bridges the gap between the Israelites receiving the law of God in Exodus and Leviticus and preparing them to enter into the promised land. Now, how many is ready to receive some promises from God? Hallelujah. How many knows God has promises for you that he's waiting to dish out, and how many is ready to receive something from God? Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now, I want you to know something. I want everything that God has for me.
That's right.
I don't want anything left on the shelf. I don't want God saying, because you didn't obey me, you can't have that. You can't have this. I want everything that God has for me. I want to walk in total obedience unto him. I want to be so close to him that when he looks around that he sees me. Come on. I want God to know that I'm serious about serving him and worshiping him. And I want to be in his perfect will. How about you?
Yes. Yeah.
Glory be to God. Now the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 1:20, it says, "For all the promises of God are yea and amen unto the glory of God by us." How many knows the promises of God are fulfilled by us? God wants to use you. God wants to direct you. And the promises of God are yes and amen. Somebody say yes.
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 And somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Man, it's easy to preach to this crowd today.
Yeah.
Woo!
Thank you,
Lord. Glory be to God. Now we see in the New Testament that the Bible looks back to this day of the tabernacle in the wilderness and gives us insight to the heart of God. If you have your Bibles, look at Romans chapter 9, verses 4 and 5. The scriptures say, Romans 9, chapter 4, verse 4 says, They are the people of Israel, chosen to be God's adopted children. For God revealed his glory to them. He made a covenant with them and gave them his law. He gave them privilege of worshiping him and revealing his wonderful promises. Verse 5 says, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob are the ancestors, and Christ himself was an Israelite as far as the human nature is concerned, and he is God. The one who rules over everything is worthy of eternal praise. Amen. Now we find here in the book of Numbers that God instructed Moses several things. We preached several weeks ago. Number one, the first step was to take a census to determine the nation's fighting strength. Number two, the next step was to get organized by putting the camp and every tribe into certain formations. They had to leave the camp one way and they had to come back another. Everybody had to be in their proper place at the proper time, exactly how God instructed it. And when everybody got in its proper place, it was a signal of the cross of Jesus Christ. Now here in this story, now God appointed the Levites for service in the tabernacle, which I want to focus on today. Numbers 1 and 50 says, "But thou shalt appoint the Levites over the tabernacle and over the vessels thereof." We preached all the vessels this past year. "Over all the things that belong to it, and they shall bear the tabernacle and all the vessels thereof, and they shall minister unto it and shall camp around the tabernacle." Now we find that the Levites are members of the tribe of Levi, which was the third son of Jacob.
The Levites were set apart by God to be caretakers of the tabernacle and aids to the priests. This is what God commanded Moses to do. Now, God did not have Moses count the Levites in the census because they were not like the other tribes. They were set apart for service for God. He wasn't going to send them out in the battle. They were there to worship God and take care of the holy place of God. The Levites were set apart as aides to the priests. We find that only the sons of Aaron were the ones that became the priests, but they're still Levites. Now God has proper steps and procedures in His kingdom. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
And how do we find those proper steps and procedures? It's found right here in the B-I-B-L-E. That's the book for me. Come on, how many knows that this book is an instruction book for us?
Right.
To get closer to God. To find the answers that we're looking for when we don't know which way to turn. How many knows that God has a word for you?
Amen.
Well, when you don't know what to do, the word of God is still alive and will show you the answer. Come on. How many knows that Jesus is that answer? He said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. And no man can come unto the Father except by me. He is the only way. He is the only way. Somebody say amen.
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 Glory be to God. Now I want to give a statement here this morning. I believe there's too many people out of step with God. They're not in the proper place. They're out of position. And they better get in position according to the cross of Jesus Christ. They better fall into place with God. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
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 Now Romans 11 and 29 says, for the gifts and the calling of God are without. What? Repentance. Thank you, Brother Curtis. I want to give you some of the differences between the priests and the Levites. We find in the scriptures that the scriptures teach that the priests were anointed and washed where the Levites were just sprinkled. The priests were made holy and the Levites were made clean. The priests were given new garments and the Levites had to go wash their own garments. The Levites were permitted to go near and work in the tabernacle, and the priests needed the Levites to complete their work. It was impossible for the priests to do their work without the Levites assisting them.
Yes, amen.
Come on, how many knows every single one of us are important in the eyes of God?
Right.
And I want you to know every single person here this morning is important in the kingdom of God. God has a destiny for you. God has a purpose for you. It's not by chance you're hearing this message today. Come on. How many knows we've been chosen to serve? Come on, how many's glad you've been chosen to serve?
Amen.
I find that the Levites also, they provided music during worship. How many knows that the tabernacle was just designed around worshiping God?
Amen.
Come on. Now, they would sing and play instruments while the priest was performing their sacrifices and their duties. They were singing praises to God. The Levites, we find, were the gatekeepers and the guard around the tabernacle. How many knows that tabernacle was worth billions of dollars?
Oh, yeah.
Come on. The Levites were the ones that took apart the tabernacle and they moved the tabernacle when God instructed them to go to a new place. Nobody else could do it because they would die.
Right. Couldn't touch it.
Huh? They couldn't touch it.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Once the Levites completed their duties, they didn't have to go and grow food. They didn't have to make a living because their physical needs were provided by the contributions of the people.
That's right.
They took care of them because they were taking care of them.
All right.
We even find that the Levites had a retirement plan. This is nothing new. They were assured that when they turned to age 50, they retired at the age 50. Uh-oh. I didn't even think about that. I'm 49 today. I'll preach hard as I can. We read in Numbers chapter 8 that they had a retirement plan. The Levites, we find, were educated individuals, for they were responsible for reading and communicating the word of God to the people. The Levites were chosen and consecrated and set aside for service. They were gifted and they were divinely equipped for service. God showed them what to do. God gave them the blueprints what to do. They were anointed and empowered for service. Hallelujah. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
My next slide, Brother Todd.
Yes, sir.
Now here's the key to the whole story. The tabernacle in the wilderness was all designed around the Ark of the Covenant. Just as everything we do today is designed around Christ. The Ark was the symbol that God Himself was present among the people and He blessed. His blessing was upon them. How many know as long as the Ark was in the camp, they were blessed?
Right.
Come on. God used the Ark of the Covenant for His physical presence on the earth. Everybody knew that God's presence was there because the Ark of the Covenant was there. The Bible says it was at the Ark of the Covenant where God would speak to the high priest Aaron above the mercy seat under the wings of the cherubim. God would speak right from that box and give Aaron the direction for the people. Hallelujah. Somebody say amen.
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 Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Now, God told Moses that he would meet right there and he would commune with man right there between the two cherubims. And during the wilderness journey, how many knows God had to move around quite often?
Yes.
Most of the time was because they were disobeying God.
Right.
Come on. They had to keep moving around. How many know somebody just keeps always moving around?
Yep.
Yeah. We've moved more in the last several years than I've done my whole life. I don't understand it, but God has a plan. Praise the Lord. How many just wants to be in God's will?
Yes.
Right.
Hallelujah. Now, during their journey, the tabernacle had to be moved from place to place. In the course of moving the tabernacle had to be dismantled and packed and carried to the next campsite, all directed by God. The next slide. The Levites were assigned the responsibility of carrying the glory of God. We see the fire coming out here. That's above the tabernacle, above the Ark of the Covenant, was the glory of God. The very presence of God was being shown for miles and miles around. Everybody knew that the presence of God was present at the Ark of the Covenant. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now, the Levites were assigned with carrying the glory of God. They had to take down the walls. They had to pack up the altar. They had to pack up the wash basin. They had to take down the holy place. They had to pack the golden candlesticks and the altar of incense. They had to take down the veil that separated the holy place from the most holy place. They had proper procedures and steps that they had to go through, and they had to follow it exactly what God said do, because if they did not do it exactly the way God said it, God would kill them right on the spot, because God is holy. Somebody say God is holy. Hallelujah. We read and we preached on it many times that the Bible says, meanwhile, the fire on the altar must be burning continually. God had a purpose and plan for this. And even when they moved the tabernacle, the glory of God was still burning brightly. And even when they moved the tabernacle, they didn't put out the fire. Come on. They didn't put out that fire. They had to pack up that glory. And they had to move that glory to the place that God said go. How many knows that God has a place for you, and you better get into the glory? You better follow what God says, or guess what? You're going to die lost without Him.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
That's not too bad for a 49-year-old. Praise God. Hallelujah. You know, we're not here to play church.
That's right.
Lives are in the balance.
Yes, amen.
And the reasons why we do what we do, all according to the scriptures that is sent before us.
Right, amen.
In the holy word of God. Paul said, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Amen. It should be our goal to be where the glory of God flows. The Levites worked in the presence of God, and they transported the presence of God instructed by God.
Yes,
Guess what? That means wherever we go, we transport the glory of God with us to our jobs, to Walmart, to JCPenney parking lot. I don't care where you go. Come on. I mean, as we transport the glory of God with us,
that's right.
Wherever. Somebody say, wherever we go. Now, David Wilkerson once said, he said, the glory is the fullness of God. He said, a subject too high for our finite minds. He said, when God gets his glory, he gets himself. He cannot parcel himself into pieces. No man receives a portion but all. Come on, how many knows that God doesn't separate himself? Praise God. When you receive God, you receive the whole thing. The next slide. Exodus chapter 33. Let's all look at this scripture together. The Bible says, and Moses said, if you don't personally go with us, don't make us leave this place. How will anyone know that you look favorably on me and on your people if you don't go with us? For your presence among us sets your people and me apart from all the other people of the earth. The Lord replied to Moses, I will indeed do what you've asked, for I look favorably on you, and I know you by your name. Moses responded and said, then show me your glorious presence. Lord, show me your glory. The Lord replied, I will make all my goodness pass before you, and I will call out my name Yahweh before you, and I will show mercy to anyone I choose, and I will show compassion to anyone I choose. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God told Moses here, says, look, I'm going to go ahead and direct you. He was fed up with the people with the rebellion. We're fed up with their sin. I'm going to send down an angel, and the angel's going to direct you. Moses said, no way, no how, God. Only way I'm moving from this place is that your glory directs our step, God. I'm not going anywhere. If you're not here, God, then I'm not going. How many know that I'm not going anywhere if God is not directing us? Come on. I want God to direct us, and I'm asking God to show us his glorious presence right here, right now.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
Amen. How many feels it already?
Yes.
Is it like electric in here, huh?
Oh, yeah.
You feel it, Johnny Mac?
Oh, yeah.
Come on. You feel it, Curtis? Hallelujah. Let's all stand here this morning on the next screen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Are you chosen to serve? Come on. Are you chosen to serve?
Yes.
Now God told Moses, he says, look, I'm going to pass before you.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah.
Uh-huh. Pass before you.
And I'm going to reveal my glory to you.
That's it.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Yes, hallelujah.
Woo.
Oh,
Sunday. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God spoke to me this week and he said this. God told me to pick up the glory and give it to those that desire it. If you desire the glory, he said, all you got to do is come and pass by. Just like he told Moses. And God will touch you. Hallelujah. How many wants to be touched of the Lord?
Yes. Amen.
Brother Bob, I want you to put on that song. To the altar, page 91. Hallelujah. And I'm going to pick up the glory. I'm going to give it to you if you want. You want it? If you want the glory this morning, glory be to God, we're going to ask you to come. We're going to do a line this way and walk this way. As you pass by this altar, as he plays the song, Bring All Your Needs to the Altar, page 91. If you want the glory, we're going to give you the glory. We're picking it up here this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Bring all your needs to the altar. Glory be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory be to God. Yes, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Come on. Praise God, praise God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. If you want it, I'm going to give it to you. What do you want? Hold on, hold on. Don't get too fast. Praise God, I'm glad you're excited. Listen to the first part of this song right here.
Walk boldly, to stand in His presence.
Come and help me pray up here, brother.
Presence of the Lord.
Lay claim to the promise He made.
Your promises are sure.
I'm almost ready.
Oh, all of
your soul can be cleansed, the flow of His fountain. His blood washes guilt all away.
Yes.
As you pass by, you're going to feel the glory.
Hallelujah. Receive.
Oh, Shandara, Mama. Shandara. Watch over these young men, Lord.
Touch over them, Lord.
In Jesus'
name. In the name of Jesus, Lord,
shine above us.
Receive the glory. Receive the glory.
Lord, keep us safe in the name of Jesus.
Come on, anoint them right there. Receive it. In the name of Jesus. Father, with the glory, give them the glory. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, receive it right now.
To the glory of God,
in the name of Jesus, receive the glory, receive the glory, receive the glory of God.
Let the glory of the Lord shine upon you, let Him be obedient to the will of God.
Receive the glory as you pass by, Lord. He said, I'm going to show you the glory. In the name of Jesus,
the Lord,
yes, Jesus, receive it.
Let the glory of the Lord shine upon you, Lord, like never before.
Receive the glory.
In Jesus' name.
Receive the glory in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, yes, Lord, direct your steps, God.
We bring your hair, Lord. Bless her in a special way, Lord. Bless her in a special way, Lord. Oh, touch Pauline today, God. Bless Pauline in a special way, Lord. Let the blessings of God shine upon her.
My,
Jesus, thank you, Lord. it, Lord. Using it as a special way, Lord. Lord, let such a blessing be upon their minds and upon our pastor today, Lord. God, upon everyone.
And able to help you bring all your needs to the Lord.
Yes, let's all lift up our hands here this morning. Come on, hallelujah.
Bring all your needs to the altar.
As we pray with everybody, did we miss anybody?
Bring all your needs to the Lord. He is so willing and able to help you. Bring all your needs to
message was for you.
Amen. Amen.
Is that everybody?
Yeah.
Praise I've been God. Chosen.
Yeah. Praise God. We're chosen to serve.
Yes, to serve.
We say it together, we are chosen.
We are chosen,
chosen to serve.
We have to be chosen.
I've had the privilege of being in some of those beautiful churches you never want to be in. In fact, there's a Catholic church here in town that we go and pray occasionally.